In this video, I'm going to explain a little bit about the flow of the chart of accounts, how it's supposed to work in the accounting world. All right. So first, I'm going to go into a sample company file here with a little bit more information. Once I get in here, I'm basically going to show you what the chart of accounts looks like again, something we've gone through before. You know, there's a different video about all the different account types, and there's a lot of information there. But the flow of the chart of accounts is essentially following the flow that is the basics for accounting. I had a client one time tell me, I said, you know, the assets equals the liabilities plus the equity. And a client told me, you know, that's not going to work for my business. And I said, well, it's going to have to, because it's how it works for every business. So there's no getting away from this. If you're doing accounting, it's assets minus liabilities equals equity. Assets equals liability plus equity. However you want to put it, that's the equation, okay? And the chart of accounts should pretty much follow that equation. So you have your bank account, current, fixed, everything down to here is asset. Then you have your payables, liabilities, long-term, everything down to here is a liability. And then you have your equity, all right? So the report for those accounts is your balance sheet. I'm going to go ahead and run my balance sheet standard for now. You can see my assets. Then it gives you my total assets right here. So my total assets equals my liabilities, all the way down to total liabilities, plus my total equity. And there's the total liabilities and equity. Okay? So that's the balance sheet. That's the flow from the balance sheet. One thing about the balance sheet that's different in QuickBooks is, first of all, you'll note here, they have balances. Okay, that's because these all have registers. When you look at your balance sheet, you're looking at it at a point in time. As of today, how much cash do I have in my bank? As of last week, how much cash do I have in my bank? Notice when you run that report, you have here, okay, balance sheet as of, not from to. Okay, it's one point in time. All right. Then we go down, well, to further on that balance sheet. All of these balance sheet accounts have registers, just like your checking account does. So when you open up your checking account, you see your checking account register. Here's all my payments, all my deposits, everything. All the balance sheet accounts have a register as well. Except one. I should throw in that little caveat. The one that doesn't is retained earnings. No register for retained earnings. But all the other ones do. Accounts receivable, register. Undeposited funds, register. Vehicles, register. Let's go down to shareholder accumulated equity, register. Okay? They all have registers. And what makes that a little bit different too is you can reconcile any account with a register. So I can reconcile my shareholder equity every year if I want to. Shareholder equity. I can reconcile my retained receivable account. And you need to watch that video on how to create retained receivable and how to reconcile it and figure out who still has open retainage. You can reconcile your security deposits. So over the years, you might have some security deposits out, receive some security deposits in. You just want to know what the balance is in that security deposits there, what is truly owed to you. So you reconcile it. And then you run a report to see only the open balances or unreconciled balances. Okay, so that's the balance sheet, the flow. Moving down the chart of accounts here, you go into your income, and then your cost of goods sold. And that's a good video to watch as well. The difference between cost of goods sold and expenses. One thing to really not get stuck on is the term cost of goods sold. This could mean for your business, you might not sell goods, you might sell services. So it could mean cost of services sold. So don't get too held up on the actual verbiage here. You just want to make sure that if it is a variable of your income, then it's a cost of goods sold. Then you come down to your expenses. After expenses, you get down to your other income and your other expenses. Okay. These non-posting transactions, they're different transaction types. They're not actually on your chart of accounts. They just show up down here in the list. Okay. So these don't post. You won't see them on any accounts. Now, what happens when I double click on my design income? If I did that on shareholder equity, accumulated equity, if I double click, there's my register. If I double click on design income, it gives me a quick report. And notice too, it says from and to. These accounts, your profit and loss accounts, are for a period of time. So if I'm running the report, profit and loss standard, I'm going to say this month to date. It's not as of today, one point in time, it's as of a period of time. Okay, I can run it for just today, and it'll give me that report, but it's still running a period today, not as of today. All right, so we're going to go ahead and switch this back to the beginning of the month, end of the month, and it pulls up for me my report, and I'm going to go ahead and collapse these, so it's pretty easy to see. You have your income and your total income, all right? And then you have your total cost of goods sold, your total variable costs. So essentially what this is saying, I have $52,000 in income. It cost me $23,000 to get to that $52,000. That leaves me $29,000 in overhead to either have some marketing expenses to generate more income next month, to pay for my admin payroll and my own personal salary as a business owner, to pay for my rent, utilities, insurance, office supplies, all that fun stuff, okay? So then we get down after that. So we have our income, take away our COGS, we get to our gross profit, and take away our expenses, we get down to our net ordinary income, because this is ordinary, doing ordinary business, but then we might have a little bit of other income or other expenses down here, and that gives us our total net income, okay? If you're doing budgeting, you want to focus on this amount here for net income, because this other income is not a standard source of income, all right? It's not part of you doing your business. Okay, so that is the flow of the profit and loss statement here, and that's explaining the flow of the chart of accounts in QuickBooks.